welcome to Constant Smiles.
What's up, everyone? I'm Rich Constantine. Welcome to this edition of the Constant Smiles podcast. I'm here with my co-host, Elijah Desmond, and a really cool guest today, Mr. Evan Meyer, who's a serial entrepreneur with a passion for artfully revitalizing urban settings with his beautifyearth.com. What's up, Evan?
What's up? Thanks, guys.
Yeah, thanks for coming. How are you today, man?
Oh, I am as swell can be. I'm very swell. The swellest of swell. Swellitude.
Well, tell our listeners just a little bit about yourself, how you came to be where you are and doing what you're doing.
Sure. It feels like where I'm at right now is sort of a perfect intersection of all of the things that I care about in my life that I've been involved in. It's pretty interesting. Yeah. I'm very fortunate that I've been able to kind of conjure up this journey and be where I'm at the moment. It's a combination really of software and art and civic duty and beautification and just showing community love and everything that I think my set of skills and also things I really care about, taking care of your stuff. The world is filled with these walls that need beauty. They are boring, bland, and blighted canvases. They are everywhere. They are outdoors for the world to see, but they're also indoors in people's offices and homes. And so we are on a mission to end ugly wall syndrome and give all the beauty to people's lives that maybe they don't know how it yet is really going to impact them. We know how it's going to impact them. Everyone knows the power of art, and that's what we're here to spread.
How did you become passionate about that? Did you grow up in Santa Monica, or how did you become so passionate about the beautification of areas like that?
Because
a lot of people just focus on the canvas in front of them, but to drive around and to walk around and picture things in much bigger scope like you do, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, well, I think it started. I became involved with my neighborhood association called the Ocean Park Association about a decade ago. Was in that for many years. Eventually became the president because I cared enough to be the voice and lead the residents' voice of the community. And during that time in Santa Monica, there was this street called Lincoln Boulevard. And Lincoln Boulevard was dubbed Stinkin' Lincoln by many. There was a lot of negotiation between who owns the street, the city or the state. And like, what's the difference? Just make it pretty. How is it? And to this day, it's like the art that has been brought there, which is now dozens of pieces, has started to revitalize these little pockets of Lincoln Boulevard. And it's really just started with one mural, one idea, one concept of like, that wall is ugly. It could be very colorful and change everything when people drive through it and bring more business into the restaurant there. And everyone loved it. And then we did another one and then another one. And then Beautify Lincoln led to Beautify Crenshaw and Beautify LA and Beautify Pico and then around the country and then Beautify Earth. And now we're a technology company that's accelerating the logistics of doing all this street beautification. Kind of like an Airbnb for beautification, matching ugly walls with artists and sponsors and organizations who love to sponsor the mural, these murals. So it's really cool. The short answer to your question is one thing leads to another, man. I don't know. Like,
yeah, it's cool how that,
yeah, you just keep going.
That's awesome. So it's awesome that your giving spirit. Before Rich got on here, or before you got on here, I was talking with Rich. I'm like, he's a philanthropist and loves to give back and has a huge purpose. I think that's awesome to get to know you in that capacity. And also a way that we get to know all of our guests is we usually ask them what their favorite song is. So we want to, I'm a DJ as well. Right. And so I'm about to put you on the spot. And I want you to know, like, no song that you say is the wrong song. It could be an old song. It could be a new song, but the song that comes to your mind right now that you wanted to hear for just 5 seconds, what would it be?
Jessica by the Allman Brothers.
Okay. Jessica.
Yeah. By the Allman Brothers.
By the Allman Brothers. How did I spell? Okay. Here we go. Here we go. I think we got it.
Surprise.
when that happens, what does that make you want to do? Like, when you hear that song, like, what's the first thing that you want to go out and do?
I don't know. Give someone a hug.
Give someone a hug. That's awesome.
That song, it's been passed down, that song. I am a musician. I have a large array of music genres. As a DJ, you know, I would first throw out, like, you know, I'm a huge fan of, like, break beats and funky house, and like I know all the nuances of electronic music, and like, you know, I would say Crystal Method should be on more people's playlist, and is less appreciated now than it was in the 90s.
I had their first couple of CDs in high school, the Crystal Method.
Oh man,
before football games.
they are like just complete OGs in the like music that you'd put on in like a chase scene in a movie.
Yeah, they are.
Hold on, Rich, you said you used to listen to that song before you went and to the football games. What college did you play football for?
Ohio U, dude.
Not
the
way.
Ohio State University. I don't need to say the Ohio State University.
I went to Indiana University. So we were Bloomington.
My best friend in college and a teammate of mine was from, he was actually the best man at my wedding. He's from Noblesville. So not too far from IU.
Oh, nice. Yeah. No, that we were definitely neighbors.
Yeah. Cool, man. You mentioned backing up a little bit to the how it all got started, that and how one thing leads to another. That very first mural that you guys did, what was it of? Because it had to have made enough of an impact to inspire others.
Yeah. Well, it was, I think it was a tree on a mountain. It was just like a geometric tree on the mountain. It was by a friend of mine. Her name is Rita. And we were just like, hey, you want to help beautify Lincoln Boulevard with me? And she's a, you know, talented artist friend I know. And the original store was it's called the Novel Cafe. They had a few of them, one in Westwood, one and two in Santa Monica. And that was like my first, not that location, but the other one on Main Street was my first office off, like, with my previous company. And I was I called it an office, but I just used to eat there every day and work out of there, right on Main Street in Santa Monica. We called us the novel llamas, was like our group of people who used to eat in there a lot. Sort of a tangent, little background on me.
How do you balance like your work and life with all the things that you're doing? What's your work-life balance like?
I don't.
All work, no balance?
All integration. Like, I think it's worth like work-life integration. You know, I think the term balance is a healthy term for just about everything in life. I think when it comes to trying to separate what you love from what you're doing I try not to use the balance approach, but more of the like, everything is, how do I make my day filled with everything that I love doing more and more often? Sometimes I give corporate culture seminars, sort of a hobby I started doing as being very, very interested in company culture of municipalities and how to really work with them to think about this actually very concept. And that is, if you don't love what you're doing, you really shouldn't be doing it. And you should start loving what you're doing every day. It's not a 9-to-5. It's a, you know, how do you, you know, I don't know, if you're bring your son to your painting project, you know, if that's what it is, right? Like, have them come help paint, or however you can start to integrate while you're going for a run. Maybe you're listening to a podcast about how you can improve either your well-being or something you're doing at work. I mean, learning, just the idea of learning anything. So I don't know. I think my answer to that question is it's trying to get to a place of like, it's all love, it's all learning, it's all good. And everything you do is an opportunity to accelerate and systematize and synergize together.
That's awesome. Sounds like you're in a really good place in your life right now. Seems like the way you know,
it's whatever stories you decide to tell yourself over and over, right? It's that's like, true. Yeah. So I make the choice to believe and create certain habits, and look, if you lose some of those habits, all of a sudden your perspective shifts. So you get a good habit, and you know, as Plato said, excellence is something. What did Plato say? Plato said something about excellence being trained and something you do every day, and excellence is a learned behavior. I'm butchering it, but he said something like that, and it was Plato.
Are there things that you do do you have any daily routines that you do either physically or for your mental health as well, that you just consistently do to keep you present and positive?
Oh my God, yes. A lot of them. You know, really my pride that I really take is when I wake up in the morning, I have really the first hour of my day set to doing all the things that I probably won't get to in the day that I really want to do. So like, and that includes working out. So I exercise 20 minutes a day. I do high intensity, full body, you know, working out. I always get focused on getting stronger. But 20 minutes a day, I don't go to the gym. I don't spend 3 hours at the gym pushing weights. I barely even use weights for the most part. Sometimes I'll throw one in there just to add some, you know, once in a while. But 20 minutes, and you can do it every day. And then it's really about creating that condition. It's more about conditioning than it is like pushing weight, you know? So that's important for me, and that's my physical health, you know, for my more like kinesthetic health. I actually practice nunchucks.
No kidding.
Yeah. They're on my Instagram. You can see some like shirtless nunchucks to like, well, I call, you know, like, it's like, it's spiritual grooves. I call them kind of like that, like groovy yoga music. I don't know if yoga is the right word, but it's sort of psychedelic in nature, but it's got a lot of groove to it. So I'll like, I love nunchucking and that stuff. It puts me in a good physical place, but really more about movement. It's kind of like dancing, like maybe like Tai Chi a little bit even. And then I will, I'll play music, either piano or guitar for 20 minutes to make sure to get that in. You can't mess it up. You can't skip. That's the thing. Like, you know, maybe a day you can miss, but like, you got to get into that routine. Sometimes I'll meditate, maybe I'll journal. But I take that time, have my coffee, take my fish oil pills, maybe some magnesium, whatever. I can't even believe I have a countertop filled with like, what, vitamins.
We're getting old, man. We're getting old.
Like, what the hell? I can't, like 2 years ago, I didn't have that. So that's, yeah, you gotta be consistent in that routine. And all of those things, I'll just add in. It's, you know, it's sometimes you swap one out. Sometimes I'll listen to an audiobook for 20 minutes. But the point is, every day you have a routine and you be consistent with the things you really care about. And that keeps me sort of emotionally, spiritually, mentally, physically balanced. And then I can like focus on problem solving. You know what I mean? Day's worth of awesome solving problems. Yeah.
Now, is there anything that you do to close out your day at the end before you go to bed? Consistently?
Less. I try to put my phone down for like the last hour, other than like maybe, you know, and you check my calendar before we go to bed or whatever, you know, just sometimes little things, but I really try to put my phone down, give myself some room to breathe and think and be with family. So those things sort of come towards the end of the day, sort of dedicated, intentional time. I'd say awesome. Maybe another fish oil pill.
Magic fish oil. Are you, so like coming up, was there somebody who was like a huge inspiration to you or mentor, and currently right now, who do you say look up to the most, whether they know you, you have a relationship with them, or you just really admire them and follow them?
Boy, I think there's a lot of people. I think the people that I like, you know, Neil deGrasse Tyson is like one of my people that I love following and watching, and you know, I very much admire him.
Did you listen to his new podcast with Joe Rogan a couple of days ago?
No. Okay, I will check it out though, because I actually love Joe Rogan as well.
Yeah, check it out.
Yeah, I think Joe Rogan has a really he takes an interesting position, and he always comes from a good place, and sometimes it's controversial, but I do feel like he pushes those things, and he seeks for answers. That's why I love Joe. You know.
Yeah.
He really does. So I think Joe's, you know, someone else from a, at least from a podcast standpoint, I think is good. But, you know, a lot of my, you know, when it comes to heroes, I think some of the, you know, the world's best scientists, you know, people who have really, I don't think so, like everyone praises like celebrities a lot of times, sports figures, and which is fine. You can praise whoever you want, whoever's important and inspirational to you. I do feel like there's an imbalance of like praising the people who have literally changed the way our quality of life forever. Like those people are not muralized as much, you know, they're not praised in the same way. It's not a, what's the word? It's not like a popular thing to be or something. I don't know, but like, I don't know why like Tesla's not on the, like everywhere. There should be a mural of Tesla everywhere. There should be a mural of Einstein everywhere. Max Planck, I don't know. Avogadro. People who like change everything.
That's interesting to hear you say that, because I mean, I don't think a lot of times people associate science with creativity and artists. But
you know, it's so artistic.
You think of test tubes and analytics and things like that, whereas the people that have changed society and the world that were scientists were so creative in their thinking.
Oh my God. They're the true artists. They've thought through how to solve some of the biggest world changing things at the grandest level. And it's to a point of even mathematizing it, right? Like where you can put constants and formulas around the way the world works so that they can be used for the betterment of humanity. I don't know. It's strange to me. They, you know, I'll say this: everyone is creative. Let me just nullify this concept right now, where people are like, "Oh no, I'm not an artist, not a creator." Creative. It's like, no, one, you don't practice. You've done it once, and you weren't good at it, so you didn't do it 1,000 times, which is what makes you good at something. But two, you are creative, and everything we do is creative because you're always figuring out how to solve problems in some interesting way and make something interesting. That's what doctors have to be creative, engineers have to be creative, lawyers have to be creative. It just depends on where you apply your creativity. That's wow. My thought on it.
And you dropped the mic right there.
Yeah. We're gonna steal that snippet for sure.
Yeah. That'll be the highlight, right? Awesome. Good stuff. So, you know, we always ask our guests, I don't know if you realize this, but I'm a serial entrepreneur. I'm a DJ, but I'm a dental hygienist. That's what I went to school for. And Rich is actually a dentist. And we always ask this dental question.
Yes.
And so if you were to go somewhere out of state, you travel there on a plane, and you were only able to bring one dental item, what would it be?
Drum one roll. Dental item?
Yep. That's toothpaste. That's Listerine.
Floss.
Good answer.
That was the right answer. Was that the right answer?
Yeah. I mean, there's no right answer, but I like that the best out of all the answers. What do you think, Rich?
Are you sure that's not a right answer?
We just say there's no right answer, but that is a very good answer.
Listerine is great, though. Like, I mean, I think it's really important that, you know, the bacteria, I have it all. So, can I do one more? Can I say one more thing? Okay. Sure. All right. So I did all the research for this, the water pick the whole world of water picks. All right. Let me just debunk the world's water picks for a second and then praise. I should be getting paid for this for them. But it was called the shower breeze. I think it's called the oral breeze now. And what you do, you probably know this. It's literally a tube for $20. You hook up to your shower. It has a valve.
Keep talking. I'm going to be right back. Keep going.
Okay. Oh, yeah. You're going to buy it. Dude, it's $100 water picks that take up counter space, take up the water at the sink, your whole thing. Forget about it.
He's probably going to take it off of his shower wall to show you.
Oh my God, he's got it. No way. It's the Occam's razor approach to water picking. It's perfect. It's meant, you do it in the shower while you're wet, you're in there, you're it's got great pressure. Uh-huh. You don't have to worry about the pressure. You can adjust it if it's too strong or too soft. So this is an unpaid endorsement for my favorite oral hygiene product, the Oral Breeze. Buy it on Amazon.
All right. So you got me pumped up for a second.
Yeah.
Because I literally just got this shipment in the mail from the founder of this. This is pretty cool. Look at this. It's pretty much what you just explained. It hooks up to your shower.
Yeah.
It's called the two shower. It hooks up to your shower and you legit just like can take a shower while you're wet and use the water flosser. And I got this burst water flosser too that you could travel with. Like if you were to travel with something, you'd probably travel with this.
But that's great.
You probably want something like this. I can't tell you about this yet because I haven't used it. I'm about to open it any day though.
That's awesome. Wow. Yes. So you feel this water. There's a thing with the water picking, and that thing needs to all be translated to the shower.
Yes. The tooth shower. Like I'm pumped up to use it. Like I could just talk to us about that. We never went on one of these dental tangents, Rich. It was actually kind of fun.
Yeah, that was good.
dental tangents. That's a good name for an album, maybe by like the Toothsayers.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Man, you are great, buddy. Thank you so much for your time. You know, we loved everything you had to say. Super real. And you know, you definitely hit the nail on the head with the scientist bomb and the mic that you dropped where you basically said everybody is creative. Like I absolutely love it. I'm a fan. Make sure, where can people find you at? Like how can people follow you?
Well, I'm on all of the social things. My Instagram is Evan Meyer Meyer. Evan Meyer on, you know, all the other things as well, LinkedIn, whatever. But Beautify Earth, really, you know, follow Beautify Earth, go check it out, make an account, go start favoriting artists and stuff. That's really the thing, you know, if it was me, if I had to get you to pick one of them, forget about Evan Meyer, go help make the world more beautiful and get involved in Beautify Earth in some way and just start, you know, seeing the world in a more beautiful, colorful and artistic way like we do.
Awesome.
Beautify
Earth.
Wow.
Thank you so much for joining us today. I hope that our listeners come away like I did with the energy to attack this second part of the day. So thanks so much for contributing and joining us today.
My pleasure. You guys are awesome. This was so much fun. Thank you.
Cool, man.
Thank you.
To all our listeners, please subscribe. We can't wait to join you for the next one. Thanks a lot, guys. Thanks, Evan.
Thank you. Take care.
Thank you for listening to Constant Smiles.